Hey guys, so I just wanted to do a quick little comparison here of Google Pixel phones and the newest iPhones from Apple. See who is the faster phones in late 2016. So we do have the small Pixel, the larger Pixel, the iPhone 7, and the iPhone 7 Plus, as you can see. So we're going to start off at the same time here and see which one comes on first, and then we're going to have a look at some of the performance things. So 3, 2, 1, let's go. Oh, that's what I like to see. Google versus Apple. Who's the best? Who is the best? We don't really know. Oh, iPhone 7 Plus is the best. Nice. Conclusive video. Oh, then Pixel XL is faster here than the old little Pixel. Why would that be? That's quite a difference, that is. So if you want the best performance on Google Cam, you know which phone to get. But we're going to have a look here how they compare then in terms of the performance. You can see we do have the nice Android, is it Nougat or Nugget? Depends on where you're from, really. All of them are up to date. I think we have iOS 10.1 here. So you just show you this as well. You can see. And we're just going to start off with a good old Wi-Fi test because we do want fast Wi-Fi here. So I think we have got it on all of them. And the Pixel has some of the best Wi-Fi I've ever seen, actually. So I think the iPhone 7s are going to struggle here. You can see we're on the same infrastructure, which is nice. So let's, in fact, are we on the same infrastructure? So yes, Virgin Media, yeah, everyone's connected to the same server. And we're gonna start with the little Pixel, little boy. What can it do? You can see, never disappoints the Pixel. Very nice score here, starting off. Although it has done better, if we look at the history, maybe we see the history on after we've done this. So just looking at the Pixel XL, which I think the spec is identical, but it does have some more space here. Oh no, it can't reach the little Pixel. That is surprising. So if you do go for the bigger Pixel, you have to have a trade-off of slower Wi-Fi, compared to the faster boot up. iPhone 7, what are you going to do for us? Are you going to destroy Google? We're going to see. Oh no, you see, iPhone 7 is terrible. When it comes to the Wi-Fi, I mean, the 6S and the 6 were trendsetters. Well, it's 6S actually, but the 7 I could never get up to 200, I don't think, ever. And it's really weird, I don't understand why. And 7 Plus, come on, don't let us down. The little inner iOS fanboy in my heart is rooting for you. Oh no. You see, what is that all about? So Google is the winner here, folks, when it comes to the Wi-Fi. No questions asked. And as I said, I'll just show you the history on the little Pixel. So you can see 219 we got once. Let's have a look at the results here. You can see, I mean, I can never get up to 200 on the iPhone 7. I don't know why, and that's even the bigger one, you can see. So if you're looking for your Wi-Fi speed, Google is the boss here. We're going to have a look at the Geekbench score as well. I will speed through this because, you've got things to do, I've got things to do, and nobody wants to sit through it. So I have it on here somewhere. So you can see the actual specs here, pretty much similar on all of them. And I'm just going to run through this. And yeah, I'll be back in a moment. So the iPhones have finished the actual test here, as you can see. Very nice scores as usual for the Apple A10 processor. Slightly better for the multi-core on the bigger one and the single core on the smaller one. Maybe that's just, coincidence, probably not worth too much worrying about, but you can see the pixels take their time a little bit in terms of doing this test, but they should be done very shortly. Someone said that the Snapdragon 821 is underclocked for better battery life, so maybe performance isn't the top consideration here. Got to say the displays on the pixels definitely look nice and vibrant in comparison to the iPhone equivalents here. I think obviously we're getting OLED for the next iPhone 8, so it is long overdue. And you can see the actual raw synthetic here is falling behind Apple when it comes to the performance. You're getting nearly twice the single core on the iPhones, and a very big multi-core kind of difference. In terms of the actual difference between these two, you can see the bigger pixel gives you the better performance here. No questions about it really, and except for the Wi-Fi, the speed, the boot up speed faster, as well as probably going to get better battery life and other stuff. So, very interesting here. I think you can summarize this video. Google has it when it comes to the Wi-Fi performance, but Apple still has it when it comes to the boot up, getting going in the morning kind of speed. And there are some other things obviously that we can check out, which I will be doing some videos on between these phones. So do stay tuned for that. Hope you find this one helpful, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.